Pakistan demands an international investigation into India's crimes in occupied Kashmir.
Pakistan has become a geography synonymous with terror. Pakistan is now Terroristan.
The Kashmir dispute should be resolved justly, peacefully, and expeditiously. As India is unwilling to resume the peace process in Pakistan, we call on the Security Council to fulfill its obligation to secure the implementation of its own resolutions on Jammu and Kashmir.
Pakistan is a signatory to the Shimla Agreement of 1972, where it clearly says Kashmir is a bilateral issue and must be resolved bilaterally in talks. This was further reiterated in the Lahore Declaration in 1998. Pakistan cannot logically be a signatory to these two agreements and yet continue to internationalize Kashmir. Pakistan blames India for aiding and abetting terrorism, specifically in Balochistan, but indigenous Pakistani terrorist groups have claimed the responsibility for most attacks on Pakistani soil. Hafiz Saeed, the head of the Jamaat-ud-Dawah, has also launched a mainstream political party in Pakistan called the Milli Muslim League. While systematic brainwashing of poor citizens provides foot soldiers, the idea of poverty breeding terrorism is flawed. Today, terrorism is an institutionalized industry and many of the top brass come from rich families. Osama was part of one of the wealthiest families in Saudi Arabia, while his successor, Al-Zawahiri, was a doctor who came from a very influential family in Egypt.
Pakistan also urges the international community to call on India to halt pellet gun attacks and other violence against unarmed demonstrators.
Pakistan alleges India's counter-terrorism and policing tactics have often employed high-handed techniques in Kashmir. But Pakistan's continued support for violent resistance in Kashmir will find few takers on the international stage, especially in a post-9/11 world. Just like Iran is routinely flayed for its support to Hezbollah and Hamas is criticized for using violence against Israel, Pakistan's case for Kashmir will continue to have few listeners till it ends support for armed struggle and international terrorism.